Good evening. On behalf of the entire Village Board, I wish to extend to you and your families a good health and a bountiful new year. I also thank you for this opportunity to share with all of you the State of the Village Address, which was originally delivered at our Village Board meeting of January 11th, 1993. When I started preparing for the presentation of the State of the Village Address, I began to review what had happened in Lynbrook in 1992. I wondered just how much had been accomplished, and a perusal of our agendas showed just how far we did come last year. We have a new, able, and talented village clerk, Carol Hansen. Carol has been in the employ of the village for over 20 years and assumes the village clerk's role while retaining her previous position as village treasurer. Bruce Adams has been appointed to the deputy village clerk's job. In addition to assisting Carol, he has, as an attorney, been extremely effective in monitoring the village's self-insurance programs. That's self-insured insurance in terms of the workers' compensation and our other insurance as well. In addition, he coordinates many of our grant applications. Our premier event of 1992 has to be the opening of our new library. The facility even made the front page of the real estate section of the Sunday New York Times. And what is especially heartening to me is the fact that our residents are using the new facility far beyond what was anticipated. The minutes from the December meeting of the Library Board of Trustees indicate that circulation is up 48%. We look forward in 1993 to the completion of the rehabbing of the old library. Natalie Lapp, the library staff, the library board, and the friends of the library are to be commended for their efforts. Grice Park has also been the site for improvements this past year. Using grant money, we have renovated the ball field, installed new dugouts, sodded the infield, and leveled the grading. Our fields are safer and our park a more pleasant place to play. I have also been told that the 1992 Halloween parade was our most attended parade yet. Thanks go to Dick Flynn, his staff, and the Recreation Commission. At the end of 1991, we lost a beloved member of the Recreation Commission, Ed Larson. We were pleased this year to dedicate in his memory the Children's Park at Remsen Street and Peninsula Boulevard as Larson Park. We also solved a long-term traffic problem over on Hillside Avenue by the creation of a mini pocket park by the West End School. Students and staff there joined in planting a tree and dedicating the mini park. They will be helping name the park later this year, as well as planting daffodils and tulips. We moved a step closer to full recycling in 1992. We passed a comprehensive local law setting forth recycling guidelines. The village acquired its first recycling truck. We were fortunate to obtain $40,000 in grant funds to use towards that purchase. The grant was received through Senator Dean Scalise' office with the help of Trustee Bob Barra. Lynbrook was a recipient, with its sister community of Rockville Center, of a New York State Award for Excellence in Government for our municipal agreement concerning the Rockville Center Transfer Station, which allows us to bring our solid waste, or garbage, to Rockville Center rather than traveling all the way to Westbury. Our emergency vehicles are our lifelines, and this year we saw the retirement of a 26-year-old fire truck at Hose Company and the delivery of its successor, a brand new Pierce pumper, truck number 424. We have in 1992 also received two new police vehicles to aid our extremely able department. In a tumultuous year of emergency calls and even a shooting, our village is fortunate to have Lynbrook Fire Chief Mike Chiarmonti and Police Chief Joseph Neve. I can't help at this point but note that Lynbrook Police Officer Bill Hall was the officer shot last year in the performance of his duties. Our lighting program has continued. In 1992, we upgraded the lighting along the main streets of our village and adjacent to all schools and places of worship. In 1993, as phase two of the project, we will upgrade the lighting on all streets south of Sunrise Highway. And north of the highway, in the eastern half of the village, we will go to Peninsula Boulevard, and in the western portion of the village, as far north as Merrick Road. This will bring us more efficient and brighter lighting through the use of high-pressure sodium. We have awarded the bid for phase two and anticipate the work to be completed shortly. Thanks also go to the village court justices and staff. Our courts this year became computer accessible to the scofflaw program, and our revenues there have risen. Speaking of the law, I should mention that this year we adopted a consumer protective law in response to numerous citizen complaints that they were being improperly towed as well as overcharged. This addition to our village code places restrictions on the amount private tow car companies can charge to tow improperly parked vehicles from private property. It also imposes an obligation upon property owners who use private towing companies to inform the people who park on their property that their cars may be towed and also how to retrieve them. Our efforts to beautify the village continue with the Environmental Concerns Committee planting daffodils for the third consecutive year. This year we planted several hundred by the entrance of the new library. In addition to the daffodils, the library has been landscaped by our DPW with plants requiring less water in accordance with a plan created by an Environmental Concerns Committee member. Members of the ECC and the DPW are responsible for the village receiving a $15,000 grant from the Small Business Administration for the planting of trees in those areas where commercial properties abut residential properties. I, for one, am excited about the acquisition of many new trees. We will be setting the date to receive bids for this project this evening. The Summer and Winter Celebrations Committee, under the stewardship of Trustee Bill Hendrick, wrapped up another successful year of concerts, games, exhibitions, hayrides, and other activities. While watching our residents enjoy these events, I was grateful to Bill and the committee for all their time and talent. Before looking forward, I must note the passing of a year in which the village continued to bring you open government. There is no board meeting which takes place without being posted and the papers notified. I also am proud of our second year of providing the residents with an informative, non-political newsletter. And shortly, a new flyer will be sent to all residents informing them of our village's new recycling program, which will fully include plastics as well as cans, glass, and newspapers. In looking to the year ahead, the first priority will be public works concerns. There will be substantive changes in recycling and garbage collection. In addition, we will be removing at least 200 dead curbside trees, a project left unattended to for a number of years. We are also exploring all of the functions of the Department of Public Works so as to determine the most efficient and economical way to bring you village services. I am hopeful of a conclusion to the Penn Sun litigation concerning the water company property in the weeks ahead. We are in what is hopefully the final stages of negotiations with Mr. Sirota prior to presentation of a proposal to the residents. The proposed project will provide the village with a needed facility and bring it to an end rancorous and costly litigation. The village municipal buildings will begin to look different as we continue to comply with the Americans with Disabilities Act, or the ADA. The Village ADA Committee, which consists of our Village Clerk Carol Hansen, our Village Attorney John Marcos, Trustee Tom Michio, and several volunteer residents, is charting our course. Later this evening, we will be setting the date for a public meeting concerning the Fire Service Incentive Awards Program. This program, an unfunded local option New York State Legislature creation, is designed to attract and retain volunteer firefighters. The Village Board will be analyzing the cost to our taxpayers and deciding in the weeks ahead as to whether to place before the voters a referendum which, if passed, would extend the program to Lynbrook's volunteer firefighters. This year we should also see the beginning of two long-term and long-awaited projects, the enclosure of Doxy Brook by the County of Nassau and the revitalization of the Lynbrook Railroad Station by the Long Island Railroad. We also anticipate the Ethics Board delivering to the Board of Trustees shortly a new comprehensive ethics law that will again place Lynbrook in the forefront as the village that leads the way. In 1992, our village became a member of the Main Street Alliance. We sent a representative to its symposium concerning business improvement districts, or BIDs. We will also be participating in a similar program planned by the Village Officials Association this spring. I have apprised the president of the Chamber of Commerce of our activities and interest in the Business Improvement District and offered our assistance when and if the business property owners decide that they wish to proceed with a Business Improvement District. I believe the village must go further in its consideration of the business districts. I exhort my fellow board members to make a commitment to expending funds for a professional planning review of our non-residential properties in order to update our zoning code to better reflect our village's needs. At this point, I give special recognition and thanks to the trustee upon whom I rely continually for his advice and for his being here at Village Hall on a day-to-day basis to respond to the daily concerns, Deputy Mayor Dominic DiCarlo. Last evening at 10 p.m., as most of us were settling in to watch the second half of the Carol Burnett Show, Dominic, as DPW liaison, went down to the DPW garage to make sure that the snow removal work was on schedule. I can't thank him enough for his contributions to this village. In closing, I wish to thank all of the members of our village family, our volunteers, our board and committee members, all of the employees, the Board of Trustees, and our concerned residents for a successful year. Thank you and good night.